Welcome, folks. This is Tom O'Brien of TFNN. We are 5 days a week. We go 10 hours a day. We go 24 hours a day on the internet at TFNN.com. Always remember, folks, whatever you think about, you bring about. Whatever you focus on grows. Hope everyone's having a great day, safe day. It's a TGIF, folks. Let's make it a great one. Always do your best. Take action on your ideas. This is a great card, and I know I read it a lot, but this is a great one for over the weekend, so you can do some really thinking about it. Doing your best means to take action. You can have many great ideas in your head, but without action upon an idea, there'll be no manifestation, no results, and no reward. Take the risk. Why not? Market wise, let's take a look at it out here. We have the Dow Industrials up 18, NASDAQ up 37, S&P's up 10.5, gold contract up $1.40, trading at $12.95 an ounce. Silver, flat, $15.07 an ounce. Light sweet crude up $1.11, $63.21 a barrel. Notes and bonds, 10-year note up one tick, 123.18. 30-year bond up 8 at 147.30. Both notes and bonds, folks, did reject lower price out here this morning. Came back into this strength. Bottom line, next week, I expect you're going to see higher price, lower yield once again. King dollar. King dollar's hanging at its highs. No volume up here, but guess what? We're up at 97.005. And if we go over and take a look at that March 9th, March 7th high, I believe it's 97.65. Let's see what we got. Yeah, 97.160. So you're laying right beside it. There's nothing up here, but guess what? You get higher prices. And that has to do, no doubt, with the euro. The euro is trading at 1.1217. And the breakdown there is about 1.1216. Now, it's been saving itself quite a few times in the last 3 months. But bottom line is that you are still laying at those lows. We have the pound trading at 130.25. The yen is at 111.71. Bottom line is that pound down slightly. Theresa May's still having a huge hard time with Brexit, and I don't think that's going to get any easier in the next few weeks. Our phone number is 877-927-6648. We get over and take a look at the gold contract first, what you're going to see inside the gold contract, as well as the XAU, HUI, and GDX, is that we had a full rejection of lower price out here yesterday. They start going topside. Today, gold contract, you get a sideways move. If we go into the GDX and we take a look at the GDX, which is the equities, you're going to see the GDX had a big movement yesterday. Went from a price point of 21.79 up to 22.54, and we're laying right there right now. We put this on a weekly basis, and you're going to see on a weekly basis, nice setup. On a weekly basis, you've done 158 million, which is going into 242, which is going into 270. Bottom line, I expect what you're going to see here is that these metals want to start running topside once again. Gold Bugs Index, same setup inside the daily or the weekly in the Gold Bugs Index. Big move out here yesterday. We went from 164 to 172. And if we bring this back and put this on a weekly basis, what you're going to see, let's get that in there, that volume in there. What you're going to see on the weekly basis is that we basically traded lower all week, rejected lower price, 82 million shares, and that is going into 132 million. So technically, that baby is set up really sweet. And we go to the XAU, same type of setup in the XAU. XAU went from a price point of 74 to 77. That's on your daily. We put this on the weekly. What you're going to see on the weekly is the same type of setup. And what we have here is that we pull back into lows with 121 million. Bottom line is that you're going into 306 million. So you're talking about some very large numbers out here. Bottom line, they want higher price. We go into the S&P. We take a look at the SPY, what you have with the SPY. Bottom line, you're at 99 cents. You're at 288. Listen, the volume keeps dying on the vine out here, but the bottom line is that you are at a higher price. If we take a look at this on a weekly basis, what you're going to see, 2 weeks ago, we did 434 million, 439 million. This week, you're at 271. You're going into 835 million. So it is one monster that you're going into. And the top of that monster is 288.86. We're trading 288.20. That top is, of course, the beginning of the downdraft in October. And, you know, we'll see how it handles it. Dow Industrials. We go take a look at the Dow Industrials, what we have with the Dow Industrials out here. Dow Industrials hit a high today of 26,487. You're 80 points off that high right now. We take a look at this on a weekly basis, and what you're going to see, we're dealing with the exact same week inside the market here. That week's going to be the week of October 12th. 26,539 was that high. And then we go over to the, let's go to the NDX 100 first, and then we'll do the composite. You take a look at the NDX 100, that's up 29 points right now. And we take a look at this one, and what you're going to see, the differential in this one is that this has already launched the October downdraft, the October 12th downdraft, and it's into now the first week of October, where we started from 7,700 and ended at 7,300. Right now, you're at 7,581. If we take a look at the three Qs and we put the three Qs on here, what you're going to see, so we can get that volume characteristic for you, what you're going to see in the three Qs is that 2 weeks ago, we did 233 million on a week. We're at 131 right now, so we're going to do about, let's say, 141. Let's say they'll put 10 million. I don't think they're going to get that much. But the bottom line is you can see the differential. And you're going into 400 and, well, you're actually going into 246 million. We took out the 475 million. We did that last week. We go take a look at the small caps, the IWM. You're going to see the exact same setup in the IWM. Now, the IWM is still the weakest indice. Bottom line, IWM, this week we've done 88 million. You're going into 116 million as well as 211 million. So what's intriguing here, folks, the way this market is set up right now is that notes and bonds, they want higher price. And this is a nice setup. This is a clean setup. What I mean specifically on a clean setup is this, is that we went top. Well, first off, you know, we go back to the first high in January. We built cars for 3 months. We go topside on the 22nd of March. Has everything. Has wide price spread. Has volume. We pull back with light volume. Rejected it. We're going higher next week. Stay right there, folks. Come right back.